Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to the magical land of Enderal. So last time, hang on, before we do that, there is no music right now. Check this shit out. How weird does it sound? How eerily silent is that? Anyway, let's read the journal, catch up on what we've been doing. Constantine said that a young mage called Lashiri can heal my arcane fever with a quote-unquote special ritual, and by doing so helped me to learn to control my magic without years of meditation. Handy, right? She currently leads an excavation site in the Northern Heartlands called Old Rashengrad, which is where we are now. Ow! Just punch the desk, goddammit! We also somewhat gated up with Jesper. Now, we haven't actually gated up with him yet, per se, but put it this way, I'm pretty sure he's into me, I'm pretty sure he wants to bend me over and give me a good shafting. Now, I'm not into men in real life, however, this just seems kind of funny to me, so we're gonna see where it goes. Anyway, so this is Lashiri. Is that even her name? Lashiri. See, this says Lashiri. Her name is actually Lashiri. And she made a point of mentioning that the old dude got her name wrong. Shit. You what up? Right. Oh, it's those guys. Let's see how well she handles herself. I believe in you. Oh god, he's attacking me. Alright, well now we have to defend ourselves. Ha-ha! Yeah, she seems to have it handled. Go, Frost Atronach of Justice! Yeah, get him! Boosh! Although it just lumbers over like, what up? Okay, so what do you have? You have nothing. Oops, open the... Oh god, what are we doing with the controls here? Sure, we'll get out the mage light, whatever it's called. Note regarding the excavation.
Hang on, what's this?
I don't know, what is it? Have you found something on the corpse of the man? Oh, you have. City guard, eh? Ooh. Sure. Light city guard helmet. Why is it upside down? There you go. We'll take the chest piece and the shield. That's actually a pretty good shield. Do we want the boots? Yeah. Yeah, we'll take the boots as well. Actually, I'll take the helmet, even though I don't want the helmet, but it's light and not bad value, considering, so we can sell it.
I don't believe it.
What?
Their orders. My assistant, Sev. It seems he's the reason these fuckers managed to take us by surprise.
What a dick! You have my deepest sympathies.
Save it for Sev when I shove this staff up his ass and fire a thunderbolt.
Yeah! Okay, well that was... less expositional than I expected. Yoink, and Drowliant pennies. Let's open up this chest, which I think might be backwards, because, you know, they usually are. Yep. What do we get? Angle iron blueprint for an iron cure? Sure, I think we might already have that, but, you know, we can sell it. Okay, so let's read this note regarding the excavation, unless it's bloody long. It is nuts. Magistrate Yela, I do understand your skepticism, but we are on the right track. Baby, I was born this way. This Scarag mage, and no, this is not meant to relativize her questionable worldview, has found undeniable coherence between these Dilgar stones and the Grandmaster's theories. Should she be right, she could be our only chance to get something like magical protection. On that note, Grandmaster Aranthiel knows what he's doing. Loath as I am to admit it, his son's mages have been nothing but helpful thus far. Merak. I don't know what any of that means. I don't know what any of that means. Well, so I was kind of hoping that said Merak, and I was like, my judge! It's Merak from the Dragonborn DLC, even though it ain't. Mercenary. It looks like you're carrying like a nice little book. Nice little book. Alright, speaking of books, bunch of ruined ones. Lead on, baby! We got things to do. Quacka!
Jesus! Shit, can you smell that? That's fire. So, these guys really are trying to destroy our research.
By God.
We have to do something. You're adept at magic, right?
I am.
Take this spell and use it to put out the fires.
We get a nice spell?
If I'm right, the mercenaries are trying to destroy the stone fragments, and we have to stop them. You take the lower part of the ruin. Try to save as many stones as you can. I'll take the upper part, and when it's all done, we'll meet here again.
Oh, I knew it.
And one more thing.
Yes?
If you should find my assistant Sev down there, try to take him alive and bring him to me. I want to take care of him myself. Okay? Then let's get going.
I knew we were going to split up. I knew it. Extinguish as many burning stone fragments as possible. Save 0 out of 8 yet uncharred stones. So we are on a time limit. Maybe it starts once we enter this door? I don't know! If there's 8 of them, I get the feeling this place is going to be bloody gigantic! My favorite, a huge dungeon. Actually, no, yeah, it looks pretty big. Looks pretty. Whoa! I guess that spell auto-equipped its. What? Is that spell auto-equipped itself? No, yeah, I can save you. Probably need to actually be able to see the fire.
There's someone there.
No, there's not. Leave me alone. Ow, you friggin' dick, man! Die! Spin attack of justice! Alright, suck on my huevos, buddy. What do you have? Human flesh, I'll take it. Do I touch the stones? Doesn't look like it. Check out the music. So dramatic and rushy. It's pretty awesome, actually. Alright, that one's out. That's okay. Do I need to go in there? Looks like I do. Oh, no, they're down here. Okay. I realize we can't really see much right now, but I don't really want to equip the spell by bringing Mage Light, you know, out, so, fuck it. I guess for now we'll just go with this. Let's make a quick save. Hey, buddy. Don't be shooting those fireballs at me. I can see what you're doing. Oh, God. I could save all of you. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, there you are. Man. Makes it really hard to see. Yeah! Stop blocking, you dick. Right, what do you have? You got a staff? No. Oh, you were blocking with the axe. Oh, yo. I wonder what that was. Rescue him from the flames? Or let him die. Well. Oh god, my HP, I didn't realize. Holy balls. Holy balls in a sack. Alright, go. Man, that was pretty good. That was pretty good. I'm working on it, buddy. Holy shit. Leave your brother alone. Yeah. It's shanked, son! Alright, let's do this again. Let's take some magic potions. I feel like I'm in a rush because of the music. It's giving me that sense of, you know, urgency. Alright, so let's get the magic spell out. It was frost or something. Fire extinguisher. Oh. It's literally what it's called. Touché. I'll save you, you backstabbing scumbag! What? Well, you know I won't. Hello? Oh, there we go. What up, G-Money, homie?
Damn, that was close. Those bastards just left me down here to die. Can you
to
believe
die?
It? Despite everything I did. Oh, forgive me.
Whoa! He can teleport? Why didn't he just teleport in the first place? Tales of the Wanderer, the well-traveled one. Let's have a quick look at this. The Wanderer tells of a Nehrimese flag breather who was combining archery with dirty tricks. Sounds interesting. It also looks far too long to read. But that might be a quest. Combined archery with dirty tricks? And he's a fire breather? Fire arrows, maybe? I doubt it's something as basic as that, but that's what it made me think of. You know, fire breather, he's shooting arrows. Why wouldn't you breathe fire onto your arrows and then shoot them? It'd be amazing! Could you imagine if you could pull that off? Like, well, I guess you'd need like a third hand, really, but... Like, you know, shoot the fire out as you fire the arrow to set it alight. That'd be pretty cool, just saying. There's a piece of coal there. Alright, let's have a look at the journal. The Art of Combats. Want to survive in Enderal's wilderness, I need to become more skillful. Perhaps I can get helpful hints in libraries. Ruins. Is this supposed to be ruins? Yeah, there's no E in ruins. Or through conversations. Yeah, okay, so that was part of the Art of Combat. Interesting. I don't think we've put out all of these, all of these burning book thingies yet. Nope, there's at least one more over here. And we spent a long time saving that dude. Excuse me, sir, I got things to do. Alright, 6 out of 8. I'll come back and deal with you in a second, sir, don't worry. If this isn't a time limit, it seems to be a fairly generous one. Whoa, get out of the way, Bush. Can I open this gate? Otherwise we're gonna be kind of screwed. Oh, god damn it! Oh, there's so many people! There's so many people, why?
Fucking
move!
Piece of shit!
You're a piece of shit! You're getting in my damn way!
Me.
We did it! We're the greatest! Oh, now we gotta find. Oh my god, why?
What?
You know what? Oh, Jesus fuck. Okay. No! Shanked! Straight up shanked. Let's reload the game. Okay, go. Go! Oh my god, damn it! Put it out. Why is it not going out? It took so long! Yeah, now I got shanked because it took like 20 friggin' minutes! Still laughing, it's not funny. Okay, go. Can't see, get out of the way! I got Mage Light out, it's not what I wanted! No! I'm gonna get shanked again! Or just shot! Okay, I think we're fine. Just need to summon the Atronach. Just frick back here. I get a fireball spell. Let's make a set. I think it's dead already. Oh god, I almost swung at it. I was about to say, why is this guy all frosty, and then I realized, oh yeah, frost atrium. Good work, brain. That reminds me, don't we have a... No, not meditate. Don't we have a shout? Can I order them into, like, the shouty things? Not really, by the looks of things. Where the hell are they? Telekinesis. Oh, here we go. All of these. Why are they all grayed out? What the hell? Oh, because I'm being killed. God diggity damn it. You know what? So... That is frustrating as hell. Let's use some more mana potions. He's dead. Great. Just what I wanted. Yeah, it's beautiful. Please just die. God damn it, man. Oh, he's the leader. No wonder he hits like a friggin' truck. Oh, God, why? What, did he kill him? I think he killed him. Alright, see if we can actually equip them now. Why have they were organized before. Damn it. God damn it. What was it called? Arctic Wind. There you go. That's what I wanted to use. I'm going to see if I could freeze them. Son of a bitch. I think they're all dead. Nope, there's another one over there. Come here, buddy. I'm going to Arctic Wind you. Oh, he's blocking. Why are you going to ruin everything? Sure, let's get some more HP. I think we need it at this point. Coins. Let's check the leader. We definitely want to check him. So, well, we saved all the books and things. I don't know how. Oh, another corpse. Gallant shoes. Novice robe of the order. Mercenary. Warhammer. Where was the leader? Was it you? Nope. Was it you? Yes. You have... Yeah, sword definitely worth taking. What about you? Warhammer? Nah. It's crap. Alright, search around this really quick. Just in case there's something good here that we missed, you know, in our rush. Seems entirely likely they'd probably put a chest or something at the end. Holy crap, dude. That was terrifying. Alright, soul gems. There's that gate we haven't unlocked yet, but we can't. Here we go. Teleport to the Sun Temple. Teleport to the Sun Temple. So probably just a really quick way back when you're done talking to this chest. Another backwards chest. Or this chick. Blue quartz, coins, potion of protection from frost, spare parts. Sure, we'll take all but the spare parts since we really haven't been crafting. Yep, that's... about it, really. That's just a blank piece of paper. Piece of paper! Alright, check over here. No, it keeps going. Oh, that's right. She said she was going to the upper level and to meet her there. Yo! That's badass! It actually worked and everything. I didn't have to pull a lever. Alright. We're still spinning. You spin me right round, baby, right round. Like, oh, never mind.
Well, I'll be damned. That's what I call good timing. I take it you were successful? What about the fragments? Did you save them?
Every damn one, because I am awesome.
All of them? Call me a pregnant Lyran. You really
are pregnant
Lyran. You won't regret it, I swear.
Better not.
What about Sev? Did you find him?
I saved him too. Oh, we can't lie. Why would I lie? I don't understand. Sure, we'll just tell the truth. Yes. Tell about Sif.
Fuck. The little shit.
I know.
I was hoping I could make him tell us who's behind all this. Well, whatever. No use crying over spilt milk, I guess. What's your name, anyway? Amidst all this, we didn't have time for formalities.
My name? It's Jason McGrizzle. Pleased to meet you.
You're pleased? Well, that's good to hear. I actually had the feeling that I was a little rough on you. Sorry for that, really. Sometimes I just have a short fuse. Anyway, let's talk about the reason you're here.
Uh-huh.
For starters, tell me how you managed to get the old ranter to trust you. That doesn't happen very often.
That's a long story. Let's tell Lashiri about the visions, the temple, and the fever.
I've got time.
Exposition! Even more exposition!
Uh-huh. So, you're saying that you learned all this, the magic, the swordplay, in such a short time? That's fascinating, to say the least.
Well, you know, it's a video game.
And
it happens.
Visions? If I understand correctly, you foresaw the death of the two apothecary?
Yeah. Probably should have told them now that I think about it before it happened, and I know how crazy all of this sounds. But I'm not crazy. I'm Jason McGrizzle.
It does indeed. But hey, who am I to judge? Here you are, the mysterious stranger who appeared out of thin air and, without much fuss, took out an entire group of sellswords. And even better, now you tell me that these skills come from studying magic for only a couple of weeks, and that you can see the future. You certainly are full of shit.
Excuse me?
Not you, sorry. I mean, I just had a strange thought. But no, that would be crazy. Way too unlikely.
Am I the reincarnation of an extremely powerful man called the Nehrim or something like that? Well, unlikely isn't a stranger these days. What do you mean?
Well, I'd like to speak freely, but I'm bound to my agreement with the Holy Order. However, I will tell Constantine and old Aranthiel about my theory. And you will probably have to be patient until the latter decides to put you in the picture. Sorry. But if my idea is correct, then we'll be in a position to really kick ass. Anyway, hold still for a moment. Ready? All right, let's do this.
Sweet, about time. Just take a look. Why am I flying? Yo, what's going on? Holy crap!
Are you all right? That wasn't on purpose. Really.
Usually when a woman with giant breasts tells me to hold still and that it won't tickle, I don't fly up in the air. Wasn't really expecting that. How about a little warning us next time?
Sorry, as I said, I didn't mean to do that. I have no idea what just happened. The ritual isn't exactly harmless, but normally you shouldn't feel more than a weak tickle at most, regardless of how it goes down. But, maybe this has something to do with the strangeness of your aura. I already said this, but it's so different.
You're not the first one to tell me that. What exactly do you mean?
It's hard to explain. Somehow complex and cold, maybe. But hey, I'm probably just out of practice. It worked, and that's what matters. Your fever will now settle down to an endurable level, and maybe even vanish if you're careful.
Hooray!
And now, I suggest you return to Constantine. I will get the stones to safety in the meantime. You need anything else? If not, see you later. We're going to meet again. I can feel it.
Hooray! So, what are these stone fragments good for? You didn't tell me yet.
Well, put simply, they're supposed to protect us.
They didn't do their job.
Aranthiel will tell you more about it later.
There were a bunch of dudes here setting shit on fire and murdering people and such. I don't think the stones actually did any protecting, could be wrong. Alrighty then, see you around.
Take care.
Take care now. Bye-bye then. We've completed taming the waves. I am nearly dead. Holy shit. So I'm part of something momentous. Part one. Or monumentous. Reports. Constantine. Or report to Constantine what has transpired. Alright, so we're gonna carry on with the main quest for now. Lashiri used the taming ritual on me, which was supposed to lessen and stabilize my arcane fever. Nonetheless, something weird happened. Something which even what is her fucking name? I'm so confused now. Lashiri cannot explain. As others before her, she called me strange. At any rate, the solution to this problem has to wait. I should return to the Sun Temple to report Firespark first. Okay, well, what is this? It takes me outside. We should probably look there first. Need a key for that. Interesting. We are bloody low on HP. Let's use some food. We do have at least some. I remember picking up cheese and such. There you go. Oh, come back to me, HP. We'll use this first. I know we have the scrolls to teleport to the Sun Temple. We'll probably use them, but we also have that scroll that teleported us to the chest with all the little wispy things around it guarding it. I do want to do that again really quick to get the booty. Then we'll probably teleport to the Sun Temple from there. That seems the most intelligent thing to do. So, yeah, first of all, we'll check outside here just in case there's something. Because, you know, sometimes in dungeons, at least in Skyrim, you'll exit, you'll be in like a ledge you can't otherwise access, you get booty, and so on and so forth. I'm gonna cut this load screen. It's quite long. Alrighty, we are outside. Whoa, hey. How's it going? Talk to me, baby. I miss you already. God damn it. Well, It's probably not a ledge we can't access, but hey, there is a chest up here. With a book, Flesh Heal. I think that's the one we already have. Oh, man. Well, water, I mean, like a friggin' knife and 12 arrows? That's crap. That's absolute crap. Alright, sure, we'll take a look down here. We'll take a look down here. Oh, okay. I am fine. I swear. There's a friggin' mage dude. Oh, God. Dude! Where's your problem? Like, what the hell, man? Not cool! Ow, 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 ow! Here we go. Unlimited power! I missed him. Great power, good luck. Mercenary iron sword, alright, nothing. Just another mercenary. Oh, this takes me to old Rashengrad. Isn't that where we were? I don't think we went in that way. Maybe we did? Maybe we did. Oh no, alright, fuck it. Let's use the scroll that we have to a strange place. I need to make sure we're full HP. Well, close enough. Fuck it. Alright, teleport to a strange place. Like I say, I'll kill all the wisps. You've seen me do it before. I'll show you what booty is in the chest. Then I'll teleport back to the Sun Temple. So, on a memento, por favor. See ya, sucker! Okay, I killed all the wisps again. Do they have anything? I don't think so. Let's open our massive chest. Second massive chest we've seen this episode, if you catch my drift. A version of fire, dexterity, potion, frost swords, invisibility, potion, morning air, potion of protection from shock, rune greatsword. I had to take a breath there. I tried to do it all in one, didn't work. Rune greatsword, do we want to kill? Yeah, sure, we'll take that. Flesh heal rank 2, we already have. Panic rank 3, we have. And spell ward rank 2. That's good, we don't have that one. So let's use it, shall we? Oh, we don't have flash shield. Heals you by 25 points of health, instantly recovers your health. Oh, we have flash shield rank 2. Okay, so that's just the worst version of what we have. Well, we'll learn it anyway. Because I'm a collector. I like to collect things. I'm collecting spells. Don't argue. Let's use our teleport to the Sun Temple. It's gonna be here. We have 4 of the bastards. Not bad. Hey, buddy, you look majestic as hell. Let's have a look at our face. Look at that. And she's like, oh, I expected someone, you know, more, basically cool-looking than you. Look at me! I look like a fucking Viking badass! Like, what more do you want, bitch? Right, anyway, let's get the hell out of here! Kami hami ha! Boop! Wait for it. There we go. Boop! Yo! Little bit of my face, dude. Little bit of my face. Wasn't there a character around here that seemed to have a quest? I think it was this guy. Maybe not. It was someone who had, like, a line we could say to them, which seemed like it probably would open up a quest. And we couldn't click it. So maybe we can now, or maybe it's just permanently broken until they patch it. I don't think it's been a patch since last time.
You don't belong here.
You don't belong here, me. Shut up. Shut up. Hey, baby. How you doing? Well, we should probably actually try and steal from her while she's asleep. Here we go.
Move along.
What? You can't be pickpocketed? You suck. What about you? Constantine? Turn around. Damn it, I woke her up. Yeah, go back to sleep. There you go.
Now, if it Damn isn't it. The prodigy, well?
Oh, good lord, we have a lot of options here. Which part of Nehrim are you from, old man, who I just woke up?
Oh, that's hard to tell. Most of the time, I was with Narathzul's order in the Kabet Mountains. But when I was younger, I used to travel a lot, not only in Nehrim. What about you?
I have
Which
no
idiot
idea.
Did you have the misfortune to be raised by? The foolhardy rebels up north? The bootlicking pawns of the Chancellor in the Middle Realm? Or the fanatic, mask-wearing, cultist oafs down south?
I like him. He's a miserable old bastard. The latter. Ostian, to be precise.
Ostian, I see. A beautiful piece of earth, actually. But these sodding cultists and their creator have done their best to make it a living nightmare. Truth be told, it was them who made me join Narathzul's fight against religion back in the days. I was a young traveling arcanist then, and wanted to make some money in Ostian's arena. Fight some rabid animals, oh, you know the story.
Rabid.
I had heard Rabbit, a lot sir. About Nehrim South, and imagined a place at the pulse of life, exotic music, adventure, beautiful women. But you know who greeted me when I reached the city gates?
A guard?
Corpses.
Oh.
They burnt their skin off and then nailed them to crosses. There were at least 50 of them. Men, women, children. And they were set up at the roadside like trees in an alley. It was atrocious. The smell of burnt meat everywhere. The screams of those who still lived and all of it only because some fool has decided that they had somehow acted against their god. I still dream of it sometimes. Well, that was when I declared war on religion. I was so sick of seeing people cutting each other's throats only because they project their own personal problems into some holy scripture or higher power. And that's not even the worst part. They're beyond reason. Why are you doing this, I asked them. Because my god told me to. What's left to say there? You can essentially justify anything with that logic. This is why this place makes me sick. We need the Order's manpower. They need our knowledge about the Piraeans, and we both do want the same thing, yes. But philosophy and freedom of thought are nowhere to be found. It's pathetic.
Good Lord. I'd like to point out, this question was just like, yo, what part of Nehrim are you from? I did not expect all of this exposition about religion and his life growing up and why he decided to turn against religion and blah de blah. I'd also like to point out, the game seems to be making a political statement about religion here, which I am not going to get involved in. I'm not touching that one. I'm not touching it. Okay, so what do we have here? But this is the problem, really, religion itself, not the people who misuse it for their own ambitions. But religion could do good too. It gives people a sense of community, and without some sort of moral guide, people would just do what they want. See, I guess I just said I was going to stay out of it, but I don't necessarily agree with this whole, and people would just do what they want if they didn't have a moral guide. True, yes, but you don't need religion to have a moral guide. There are plenty of people who get brought up, you know, outside of religion that are told right from wrong. So I don't think religion is the only thing telling people right from wrong, and I think people who say that are incredibly, you know, shallow-minded. I said I was gonna stay out of this, but whatever. But is the problem really religion, really religion itself, not the people who misuse it for their own ambitions? That's probably more than what I would say. I don't have a problem with religion. There's just specific religious groups or people in specific religious groups, maybe not even the whole group, that just are fucked up, basically. So we'll go with that. Alright, so we'll go with that.
Yes. And no. On the one hand, yes, a happy person will most likely never become a murderer, no matter if he or she follows the teachings of this creator or some Quiranian philosopher. But if something happens to this person, hunger, fear, shattered dreams, a peaceful ideology can make all the difference. What is religion, after all? It's a guide to live life, a set of values. And even if it's just one line in the Holy Scripture that says, kill the infidels, how likely is it that a broken man will interpret it in a peaceful way? If you want a justification to spill blood, you will find it. If your religion was ambivalent to begin with, even better.
And most of them are.
There's a lot of discussion about that on Kira. And it drives me mad to hear people prattling on about how it's all a matter of interpreting the scripture in different ways. Blazes, if your ideology is so peaceful, why does it say, slayeth this, slayeth that, rather than just get along? It's pathetic.
Well, obviously, yes. If your religion literally says, yo, kill people that don't agree, that religion's just a little bit fucked up. In other words, a truly peaceful religion shouldn't have ambivalent parts at all. Well, certainly not when it comes to murder, no.
Yes, go on. Try to justify a massacre like the one in Ostian with a philosophy that consists of only two principles and nothing more.
This conversation is still
respect
going.
Respect those around you, and killing is bad regardless of the motives. Good luck.
Holy crap, it's still going. But religion could do it. Shut up. I couldn't agree more. Religion is dangerous. I had to find out that out the hard way. I mean, again, that's not what I agree with exactly, but I kind of want to end this conversation because it's very long and it will offend certain people. I couldn't agree more. Fuck it.
Especially if people don't keep to themselves with it.
Yeah, woo, down with religion and also atheists and everyone else in the world. Everyone that is the same color and a different color to me. Woo, and sexual identity and gender and so forth. Who is in the temple of... Okay, so we finished that. Bloody hell. You know what, let me move because I feel really weird standing behind him crouching like this. One up. Don't go back to sleep. Okay, so we can just go with the whole, she did a ritual on me, and tell me more about your order's history, who are you exactly, how did you come to be, who in the temple is part of your order, I'm having trouble telling you apart, fuck it, let's just carry on. Lashari performed the ritual on me, there were problems, an old Rashengrad.
Yes, I know. She's already told me everything. Good work. Even though part of her report seemed to be a bit enthusiastic, but I'll leave the judgment to Aranthiel. He wants to talk to you anyway. Seems you've caught his interest.
Sweet. I may have just spilled a tiny little drop of peach water, but it's on my mouse pad, so one second, let me just clean that up. There we go. It's delicious, though. Alright, so, tell me again, who exactly, yeah, good work, Brand. Who exactly is this, god damn it, I dropped the thing, I cleaned the drop up, son of a bitch. Who exactly is Aranthiel, that person.
Didn't I tell you that already?
I wasn't paying attention,
He's
man.
He's the highly esteemed, holy, grand master of the Order. Tilor Aranthiel, son of Lorius the First. Praised be his name.
Praised be his name.
An old legend, risen from the dead, or something like that.
So he's Enderal Jesus. Okay, I gotcha. Where can I find him?
In the Emporium. The last building on the left side of the temple. Just tell the guard that Aranthiel has asked for you, and they will let you in.
Okay, then.
Ah, yes. Before I forget, my dame Lucy has left a token of gratitude for you. It's your choice. Do you want a book, an old map, or a bag of pennies?
I want the treasure map. I've never actually done a treasure map in Skyrim. I know they're a thing. I remember finding them. I never actually tried to find the treasure, so we're going to go with that, because I kind of want to try it out. So give me the treasure map, boss!
Very well. Now get a move on.
Move
along,
though.
I'm sure we'll talk again later.
I'm sure we will. I'm so old and miserable. Let's have a look at the treasure map. I think they used to be in casual scumbag, random crap clutter section. Though I don't see it. Are they here? Are they here? It's gotta be here, right? Treasure map. Treasure map. Oh, here we go. Temple Ark. What? What? So, okay, hang on. I think where's this temple? They spelled temple wrong, by the way. They put P-E-L. Whatever. I think... that is supposed to be the Sun Temple that we are in, probably. So it seems to be a bit northeast of that, maybe like on the northern edge of a river, I think? Is that what I'm looking at? I don't even know. I don't even motherfucking know. All right, let's get out of here and go find this person we're supposed to be speaking to, shall we? Away! All right, we are in the Emporium. Let's go find this guy.
Who are you?
I'm Jason McGrizzle. I'm the main character. It's nice to meet you. I see you can actually just make brooms appear in your hand. It's quite a trick.
Have you heard? Apparently the Blue Islands Coalition sent an emissary here to Enderal. Despite the wars. They are bold. You gotta give them that.
I sure do, yes. Like your voice, by the way. If you're the voice actress, hit me up. MrAndersonLP on Twitter.
Because of a suspicion is madness.
Well, mind if I take a seat to you?
The mercenaries.
Aye.
This Pigast said that they were after the Signet Stone, and if they succeed in getting hold of it next time, then the Black Guardian alone knows how to stop the cycle.
The cycle? Listening to you talk almost makes me forget that all this fuss here is merely based on some bad dreams you and your Nehrimese friends had.
The threat is real. Deny it as much as you like, but deep inside, you feel it as much as I do.
His voice is badass.
Teela, this... you're a commander, and a commander doesn't care about feelings, but about facts.
Hi.
You have made this mistake before, Teela, back then in Kira, and we all
Natara,
know...
Natara, the mission will happen. I'm sorry.
You have a visitor.
Okay, so badass,
so,
in fact.
You are the prodigy everyone is talking about. Interesting. I am Teela Aranthiel. Son of Lorius the First and Grandmaster of the Order, and I'm honored to meet you. What is your name?
Okay, so, his voice is so badass, in fact, and he's of an important rank that I'm calling it now. He is evil. He is backstabbing people. He's gonna backstab us. He's behind maybe everything. So, yeah, he's a bad guy. I can tell just because he has a bad guy voice. So they have cast the voice actor in that way specifically. I can tell. Jason McGrizzle, you want to see me?
Yes, and I will come straight to the point. You are here because I believe that you are special.
I am.
Humanity faces a threat that needs to be stopped. And to achieve this, you are indispensable.
I'm also that, yes. I've been told I'm special my whole life. You're talking about the Red Madness, aren't you?
Among other things, yes.
Among?
I do not need to explain to you that the present situation on Vin is chaotic. The wars, the living dead.
So it's Vin.
Common people who are losing their minds, to name only the most obvious. What most people are not aware of is the connection between these events. You, however, have encountered it, as have I.
You're the connection. The visions. So you know where they come from. Are you the one causing them? Wouldn't surprise me. According to now, this guy's a bad guy. Mark it down.
I do. And I will explain everything to you. What it means, who we are, and what your part in all of this is. Come, follow me.
Oh, but I just took
Maybe
a seat.
You all know who I am. My entire life, I served the gods who ruled Vin. Until their death 2 years ago.
He's not moving.
What you probably do not know is that the one responsible for their death is my son, Narazul Aranthial. He hated the Lightborn because he believed that they robbed mankind of their right to freedom. So he strived to overthrow them. He formed an army and declared war on them. Thus, on me, a servant of the Lightborn as well.
Okay, you can carry on. So, he's gonna pretend that he is with the Lightborn and that his son betrayed him. No, 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 I bet you were with your son the whole time.
Ended in a battle 30 years ago, which Narazul won. He killed every single survivor except for me, and locked me in a dungeon on Nehrim. I still do not know why he spared me.
Because it's all a ruse, you're actually with him! But you managed to free yourself. If Narazul was your son, why did he hate the gods so much? Shouldn't he have been, I don't know, devoted to them? So the Lightborn are really dead. If you or the Order of the Gods acknowledge that fact, why do people not know about it? We'll go with that, yeah. Why do people not know if it's actually dead?
Good question. Because at the moment, stability is the highest good. Even more so, considering what we are facing. The rulers of Kira and Kile both made the mistake to acknowledge the death of the gods to their people, and the civil wars that followed in their countries are evidence of the chaos that such a revelation entails. Enderal is the cradle of the Order of the Gods, the epitome of theocracy. It is unthinkable what would happen if we confirmed these rumors. I am sure you understand this. Maybe when all this is over, that will change. But for now, it is imperative that we deny all rumors of that kind.
Okay, so the standard, like, you know, the leaders or the gods or whatever are actually dead or gone or missing, and we're not going to tell them. So they do that thing in Dark Souls, like in Dark Souls 1, you know, spoilers here, there's no gods left in Anor Londo, kind of. And for example, in 5.89, another sort of spoiler here, Cid gets turned into an Oglop. Can't tell the people that a fucking Oglop is, you know, their regent. But you managed to free yourself. Okay, so if he was your son, why did he hate the gods? Shouldn't he have been, I don't know, devoted to them? Hmm?
There were circumstances favoring the development. But it's a long story, which we won't discuss now.
Darn. But you managed to free yourself, huh?
Yes, after more than 30 years. When the death of the gods made the magic around the prison disappear. And during my escape in the northern mountains of Nehrim, I also had them for the first time. The dreams.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about these dreams. Were they of me? Because I've been dreaming of you, baby. I want his cloak. It's kind of cool looking. It looks like mine, but red. Red is a much nicer color than brown. I think most people will agree. Going swimming, going swimming, going swimming, going swimming.
I always saw the same glaring, terrible light. Heard screaming, and I felt like I was burning up from the inside. And above all, like a veil, there was the knowledge of imminence. At first, of course, I dismissed these dreams as the delusion of a man close to death.
I hate following dudes in Skyrim, man.
So I concentrated on making it through the mountains somehow. 2 days after my escape, I was completely exhausted, and I would have died if a former acolyte of my son had not found me.
This is quite the story, good lord. An acolyte of your son, but one that your enemies then?
Yes, but he did not recognize me.
Oh, come on!
He brought me to their headquarters instead, an old monastery in
the mountains. Who easily his father?
The others were aware of my identity, but for whatever reason they did not kill me.
Sounds very circumstantial,
maybe
sir.
Maybe because they thought that the death of the Lightborn had made me insignificant. I do not know.
You are so full of shit. Still, so full of shit. I don't believe this story at all.
After my recovery, the dreams continued.
Go on, move!
At first, I doubted my sanity. But after some time, I told the leader of the mages, Constantine, about them.
Constantine!
He said something that I had never expected. I was not alone. He, as well as many others, magically gifted on Vin, dreamed the same dreams. And the more we talked about the matter, the stronger our suspicion grew, which is now to be the truth.
My God, move quicker.
The dreams, they come from the same place. They are a shared memory.
Shared memory? You mean the dreams originate from a what? A common mind?
A collective subconscious, yes. I know that you can feel it too, and probably far more intense than we do. But like you back then, we were not able to make sense of the images. So we went looking for answers in the remains of the civilization that was before us, the Pyreans.
Thus the excavations like an old Rashengrad, what did you find?
Three things. First, there were many civilizations before us, and before the Pyreans. Maybe hundreds, maybe thousands. Second, the history of each civilization unfolded, and still unfolds, according to a pattern. They emerge, they blossom, and at some point, at the apex of their existence, they simply disappear, without any trace. And third, everything that has happened in the past years, and which is still happening, indicates that this disappearance lies ahead of us. We are part of an eternal loop, a cycle, and our cycle is approaching its end.
Okay, so what do we have here? More? You mean the end of humanity lies ahead? Sure, we'll ask that.
Yes, it does. At first, we considered it absurd. As probably you do at this moment. But there came a moment when we simply could not deny it anymore. We began to study the history of the Pyreans more intensely, and the parallels were extraordinary. In its early days, the Pyrean Empire was split up by a disaster, just like Vin was split up by the Starfall after the reign of the Eterna. Also, the Pyreans had a ruling caste who declared themselves gods after the catastrophe. The two castes of the Sun Priest. They, too, ruled until they were overthrown. This overthrowing was followed by an outbreak of wars and chaos. And then, just like that, the Pyreans ceased to exist. They knew it was imminent, but they could not prevent it. They called this event the Cleansing.
Bloody hell. Alright, how in blazes can an entire civilization just disappear?
That is the question we need to find an answer to. The end was not violent, at least not in a sense as we
know. She got the praying chick.
There was no natural disaster, no magical explosion, no plague. Even though there was war in the Pyrean Empire before its ruin, when the cleansing happened, it was as if all living beings simply fell down and died. It is ghastly.
Okay, so when do I come in? When do these visions and my... Oh, hang on, we have an extra... Oh, fuck! I clicked it.
This is the reason why we need your help. Not only episodes of history recur within every cycle, characters do as well.
Characters recur? You mean like reincarnation? You mean like the Nerivarine?
Yes. The Pyreans call them the Emissaries. They emerge very shortly before the cleansing occurs, like a law of nature, an answer to the Red Madness. And I am one of them, as are you.
Sweet, I'm important.
While I take on the role of the ruler, you take on the role of the prophet.
I've always wanted to be a prophet. I'm supposed to be a prophet?
It's just a description. Call it what you will. But without doubt, it is the truth. Your story matches the descriptions perfectly.
I'd like to point out, if you've ever heard of the band The Lost Prophets, the lead singer, I think, or at least one of the singers in The Lost Prophets, actually got arrested for like 25 years or something, or sentenced for like 25 years, because they had a bunch of child porn on their PC, including some they'd made themselves. Bit fucked up, right? Anyway, so, why me?
I do not know. Firespark the Mage has told me your story. And even though your fate is tragic, unlike me, you were insignificant before your change.
Hey, that's not true.
So maybe everyone can become an emissary, or we simply have not understood the pattern yet.
And what defines this prophet?
On the one hand, your power. You carry the potential to master any skill within a fraction of the usual time needed. I assume you have already realized this.
Unlimited power!
On the other hand, your ability to look into the past, and therefore into the future.
Naturally. They're the same thing. Into the past and therefore into the future? What do you mean, you crazy old goon?
Your visions are a window into the past. And as every cycle is based on the same events, it is a window into the future as well. You can feel the thread this world is woven with. And because of that, you can see things that have happened, and thus will happen again. This gift makes you indispensable to us. And it is why I want your help.
Most intriguing. And if all of this doesn't interest me, then what? I'm not going to ask that, because it does. What's in for me? Sure, it sounds like something I'd ask.
If it is wealth and power you seek, you will have
yes.
It. The Order has enough of both.
What about women? You got a bunch of them? When do you think we can overcome the cycle in the first place after hundreds of civilizations have failed? Yes, this sounds like the Dark Souls cycle thing. Why do you think we're going to be any different?
That is the wrong question. The correct question is, what alternative do we have? To wait and die?
Man has a point. Alright, I'll help if I can, because, you know, why would I not? You've offered me money and power, and thus women, because if you don't have money... Put it this way, what do women want? Besides, I mean, like... Okay, let me rephrase this so that it's not incredibly sexist. What do whores want? They want someone with power and or money. If we have both, we can get the whores. Women are not whores, let me just point this out. But there is a subset of women who are, which is what I'm interested in. So anyway, if I can help, I will try to do so because, you know, end of civilization, money, women, power, etc., etc. What?
If it is wealth and power,
God bloody damn it! No.
The Order has enough of both.
I said I'll help.
Good. However, there's one more thing before the actual work begins. I want you to join our Order, and to do so, you have to pass a test, a trial.
This is where he's gonna try and kill me. I guarantee, I still don't trust him, just so we're clear. This trial, he's setting me up to be killed, I can tell. What kind of test? Join your order, is this really necessary? I'm the motherfucking prophet, bitch!
It is. Whatever you think about our story, we are the only faction that is strong enough to oppose the cycle. If you want to be part of our mission, you need to have access to our knowledge and resources.
Then give it to me.
There will be voices in the order speaking against your admission, as they are speaking against the presence of the Nerimese mages. Consider it an honor or a necessity. It is up to you.
I'll go with both. What kind of test? A sexy test?
It is the trial the novices have to pass in order to be exalted to the role of a keeper. Only the best students of the Squalor are allowed admission, and even though you have not been a novice, I want you to take it too. At this very moment, two novices are on their way to the testing grounds. I have informed them about your arrival.
I feel betrayal coming, I really do. Who are these two novices?
I have only a slight acquaintance with them. However, I know that they are both very talented and have been working hard toward the test. But see them for yourself.
Oh, I will.
We're gonna find them. You've already informed them. How could you have known that I would agree? Yes.
I had a hunch. Let us leave it at that.
I don't like you. Very well, we're gonna find them.
At the border to the Heartland, near the Whisper Wood. They will be waiting for you there. Take the Myrit, talk to Signet Master Bartar, and hand him this package. And then follow his orders. Ah, one more thing. It might be self-evident, but keep your knowledge about the death of the Lightborn to yourself. I do not believe you can do any real harm. But in the worst case, path-abiding people will consider you a heretic.
And they'd be right.
After the cycle has been stopped, we will deliberate upon how we deal with the matter. If and how we tell our people about it. But not now, that is for sure. No, leave. The sooner we can dispense with this formality, the better.
Okay, he's gonna send me away. Can I throw myself off the edge here? We have to test this. Let's read the journal real quick. I learned of two things. The world awaits an event called the Cleansing, in which a whole civilization, ours, will disappear without a trace if we won't stop it. Also, it seems that I am a messenger. People who play a divisive role in the fight against the Cleansing. That is why Arianthel wants me to formally join the Order by taking the same examination which novices of the Order have to take. I have to meet Signet Leader Jurek Bartar at the border of the Heartland. Alright, so there's just a quick catch-up in case you zoned out and paid no attention to any of that. And now we're going to try and fling ourselves off of the edge. They invisible walled it! No! Why would you do that? God damn it, man. They won't let you kill yourself. Son of a bitch. You know what? No. TCL. You can't stop me. See ya, suckers! Yeah! Splint. Alright, now I'm happy. Okay, so that's gonna do it for today's episode. Thank you all for joining me. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, as usual, I always appreciate a like, and thank you to everyone that does. And I will see you next time for more Enderal.
Yes, it makes sense.